the sadhu are that he is tolerant, merciful, and friendly to all living entities. He has no enemies, he is peaceful, he abides by the scriptures, and all his characteristics are sublime.
सुहृदः सर्वदेहिना अजातशत्रुवः शान्ता साधव साधुभूषण. इन द प्रीवियस वर्स कपिल देव हैज रिकमेंडेड दैट सैव साधुषु कृत. व्हाट इज दैट प्रसंग अजरं पासम आत्मनो कवयो विदु सैव साधुषु कृत मोक्षदारम अपावृतम. देयर आर टू थिंग्स, कंडीशन लाइफ एंड लिबरेटेड लाइफ. 8,400,000 फॉर्म्स ऑफ लाइफ देयर आर. जलजानवलखानी साबरा लखविंशति. 9 lakhs forms of life in the water, jalajanavulukhani, the child mimic. Savaralukhavinsati, the trees and plants, there are 2,000,000. Savaralukhavinsati, kirmayo rudra sankhaka, and the germs and insects, reptiles, there are 11 lakhs. Pakshinang dasalaksham, then birds, there are 10 lakhs of forms. Then beasts, animals. So there are 3,000,000 forms. And then human beings, there are 400,000, very small quantity. Of all the living entities, the human forms, they are very small number, 400. Asiti chaturangas chaivo. Asiti means 80 and chatura means 4. So 8,400,000 species of forms. So, prasanga ajarang pasam atmana. Atma is the same, spirit soul. He has got the same form, but they are different dresses. They are having different dresses. Just like we are sitting so many, as human being, we are the same, but we have got different dresses. Similarly, atma, the soul, the spirit soul, is the same. There is no difference. Therefore, pandita samadarshina, one who knows what is the form of atma, he sees vidya vinaya brahmani kavi hastini samadarshina. He sees the animal, the cats and dogs, and a learned brahmin. Samadarshana. Samata means not that Brahman is equal to the dog. No, not that. But he sees that Brahmana is also a spirit soul and the dog is also a spirit soul. So this conditioned life, dog has got a conditioned life. I have got a conditioned life, we have got a conditioned life. We are all conditions under different, and according to the condition, we have got different bodies. Karmana daivanatrena. These conditioned life, different forms of life, we have got daivanatrena. By superior, superior administration. Netrena means netritya, leadership, superior leadership, just like Jamaraj. Karmana, according to my karma, he offers me some body. Daiva netrina. Jantar diho papat. Karanam gunasangasya sadasat janma junish. Karma, guna karma, vibhagasa. Guna and karma. Just like here in the practical world, you can work as an engineer, karma, if you have got the qualification. If you have got the qualification of a shopkeeper, you cannot act as engineer. That is not possible. If you have got the qualification of a teacher, educationist, then you can become a teacher. See, the whole world is going like that. Guna karma, vibhaga. So guna means we are, according to our position or according to our mentality, we are infecting some guna, satarajatama guna. So guna karma, guna karma vibhaga. Very scientific this is. You can become, if you acquire the qualities of a brahmana, then, and if you work as a brahmana, then guna-karma vibhagasa, you become a brahmana. If you have the qualities of a kshatriya, and if you work as a kshatriya, then you are kshatriya. If you have the qualification of a mercantile man, businessman, and if you work as a businessman, or cultivator, then you become Vaishya. This is very scientific. Not that one is classified according to the birth, no. According to qualification. Just like there is a medical association. Medical association does not mean all the medical men in the association, they are born of the same family, no. They are born in different family, but because they have got qualification and working as medical man, they are admitted as a member of medical association or member of bar association. This is practically. Similarly, if you acquire the qualification of a brahmana and if you work as a brahmana, then you are accepted as a brahmana. Similarly kshatriya, similarly vaishya. This is. It is the authoritative statement of Narada. Jasahi jat lakshanam proktam varnabhivanjakam. In the Bhagavad Gita, varnabhivanjakam, how to decide to which class or which caste a certain man belongs to. That there are symptoms. Satta saucham samam damam, kanti arjamam, jnanam vijnanam, astikam, brahma karma svabha. So, Narad Muni says, jasahi jat lakhanam prokta. These are the symptoms. So, if such symptoms are visible in another place, then tattena iva vinidhise. Siddhartha Swami has given his note that birth is not everything. One has to acquire the quality. Then he will be classified. Prasanga ajaram. We are attached to some quality and some work. In this way, we are getting different bodies, one after another. This body finished, we create another body. This life is creating another body. This is called prasanga, ajaram. Attachment to the material qualities, we are conditioned. And suppose we have got now human form of body, or in a very rich family, that is all right, but it will not continue. You have to give it up. And any moment, by the superior authority, when it is ordered, immediately please leave this position. You have to do it. This is called conditioned life. You cannot stay in any status of life for all the days. If you think that I am American, I am very happy. That's all right, you are American, you are happy, or Indian, you are very happy. You have chalked out your plan how to continue happiness. But nature will not allow you to stay. Devi jesa agunave mama maya durattaya. As soon as nature will call back, please give up this post. Now take the post of a dog. Karmanada imanatrana. You have acted. You are given the most exalted form of life, human being. You did not act as human being, you acted as a dog. Now you take the body of a dog. This is karmanada imanatrana. Therefore, we must be very careful in this human form of life. Our aim should be how to become a devotee. So, to become a devotee, Krishna conscious, because that is the path of liberation. Janma karma me dibbam ju janati tattata takta dihang punarjanma nehiti mamet. If you want to stop punarjanma, great personalities in India, they used to go to the forest to stop this repetition of punarjanma. Just like Vishwamitra Muni. Vishwamitra Muni, when he approached Maharaj Dasarath to take with him Ramchandra and Lakshman, their boys, to kill the Taraka Rakshasi. There was some disturbance. So although Vishwamitra Muni could kill, but no, that was not the Brahmana's business. It was the to kill, it was the to punish, it was king's business. So therefore they approached. So at that time, Maharaj Dasarath greeted Vishwamitra. Just like when we meet a friend, if he's a businessman, suppose he comes to see me, I am a sannyasi, and he's a businessman, I ask him how your business is going on, because he's engaged in that way. And the gentleman who comes to see me, he will ask me, Swamiji, how your preaching is going on. He'll not ask me how your business is going on. So, the punarjanma jayaya ohishtam. The brahmanas, the learned rishis, sages, they are specially engaged for punarjanma jayaya, to conquer over the process of repetition of birth and death. That is the highest occupation. Every man is meant for that, punarjanma jayaya. Unless we conquer this process of punarjanma, bhutta bhutta praliyate, and if we simply waste our time like animals, eating, sleeping, sex intercourse and defense, then it is animal life. Especially in this age, they cannot distinguish that what is the animal life and what is human life. They think the dog animal, he is sleeping on the street and I am sleeping on the 20th floor of a nice apartment, therefore I am civilized. The Shastra says no. Either you sleep on the street or on the 24th story of apartment, you are sleeping. You are not doing any other thing. Simply, the dog is eating without any plate, and suppose if you are eating in a golden plate, that does not mean the taste of the foodstuff has changed. No. the foodstuff given to the dog on the street without any plate and the foodstuff given to me in a golden plate, the taste is the same. And the value, food value is the same. So we have to see in that way, that to improve the quality of eating, sleeping, mating, the dog is having sexual intercourse in the open street. And if we have sexual intercourse in a very secluded place and very nice bedstead, that does not change the quality. Therefore, we should know it, that simply by eating, sleeping, defending and sex life, that is animal life. Human life is meant for how to become free from this process of repetition of birth and death. That is liberation. So, here we have discussed last night that prasangam ajaram pasam atma, the bondage, conditioned life, more and more tightened. Jagyarthe karmannatru lukayam karma bandhana. If you do not engage your life in activities of Krishna consciousness, that is called jagga, jagga purush. Jagga means to sacrifice for the satisfaction of the Supreme Person. That is called jagga. Atapvam vidija sreshtha varnasama vibhagasa varmasama vibhagasa saṃsiddhi haritosanam. If you want perfection of your activities, different men have got different activities, that's all right. But try to make it perfect. Saṃsiddha, siddhaye, brahma siddhaye. We have discussed all these things. And how it can be done? Saṃsiddhi haritosanam. If you satisfy Krishna, Hari, by your talent, by your activities, then you are successful. That should be the aim of human life. Sarva dharmān parityajya māṁ ekam. Don't try to engage yourself, entangle yourself, for repetition of birth and death. So how this can be achieved? That is suggested in the last part. Saiva sadhusu krita. The same attachment as you are attached to these material activities, if you transfer that attachment to a sadhu, then your life is successful. We have got attachment for money, we have got attachment for woman, we have got attachment for nice house, we have attachment for our country, for our society, for our families, and so on, so on, so on. That attachment is called ajaram pasam. Pasam means rope. If you are tied up with a rope, hands and legs, then you are helpless. So we are actually tied up. Daivijisha gunamai, that's what is called guna. Guna means rope. We are tied up. We are not free. And it's like we are trying to go to the moon planet so many years. But because we are not free, still we have not been successful to go there. So there are so many planets within this material world. We can go. We have got now machine, very speedy machine. But why cannot go? Because we are conditioned. You cannot go by your whims. You must be qualified to go to certain planets. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Janti deva vrita divan, pitrin janti pitri vrita. Bhutani janti bhuteja. Madhyajinopi janti mam. So, if you want to go, you must qualify yourself. Otherwise, it is not so easy. Just like if you want to go to America, you must have qualification, you must have your visa, you must have your passport, you must have the, so many things. If you want to immigration or if you want to go as a visitor, similarly, the other country, if there are so many processes you have to undergo from this country to that country, is it possible that you want to go to another planet without such qualification? This is futile attempt. It is not possible. Therefore you are conditioned. It is called condition. We cannot go, we cannot move freely without being sanctioned by the superior authority. So we generally say, not a blade of grass moves without the sanction of God. Similarly, we cannot do anything. Daivijesa, God does not take as the supervision personally. Parasa shakti vividhaiva siyate. Natasya kajyam karananca vidyate. In the Veda, Sitashata Upanishad. He hasn't got to do personally, but he has got so many agents to do. Parasa shakti vividhaiva siyate. He has got some. They will do. You are not free even to twinkle with your eyelids. That is also being controlled. That information. You are moving this hand very freely. It can be immediately paralyzed. I am claiming that it is my hand. What is your hand? It can be stopped immediately. Your eyes, it can be stopped. So we must know that you are conditioned. This is conditioned life. And how you can improve conditioned life? Therefore, our business is how to become liberated from all these conditions. And that can be done only by Saiva Sadhu Sukrita Moksha Dharamma Pabrita. If you have got so many attachments for so many things, if you turn all these attachments to a sadhu, sadhu sanga, sadhu sanga, sarva shastrika, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advised, sadhu sanga, sadhu sanga, sarva shastrika. In all the shastras, they advise to associate with the sadhu. Tasmad dusingam utsajya, bhaja sadhu samagama. Even Chanakya Pandit, the great politician, bhaja sadhu samagama, asasanga tyagi vaishnavacha. Grihastha Vaishnava, householder Vaishnava, he asked Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, what is the duty of a grihastha, householder Vaishnava? So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said in two lines, asasanga tyagi vaishnavacha. Don't associate with nonsense or sadhu. Asasanga tyagi vaishnavacha. One line. A Vaishnava's behavior is to give her the association of demons, non-devotee. Because sadhu means devotee. Sadhu reva samantha. So it is very, essential to avoid the company of a sadhu. But at the present moment it is very difficult to find out the association of sadhu. Therefore, our teeny effort is this Krishna consciousness movement to create an association of the sadhus. So people may take advantage of this association and then his life becomes liberated. And that is the aim and object of this association. It has no other object. People may say so many nonsense things, but our only object is that, as therefore we have given the name association of Krishna conscious person. Krishna conscious means sadhu. Because Krishna says, yogi nama pi sarvesham madgata antaratmana sadhyavan bhajati juma same yuktatam. He is first-class yogi. Who is that? Who is always thinking of me. And Krishna is advising, manmanam bhava mad bhakta mad jaji mang namaskar. Four things only. It is not very difficult thing. Always think of Krishna, Manmana, and without becoming devotee, how you can think of Krishna? You can think of your business, you can think of your dog, or you can think of your family, or you can think of your lovable object, woman or man, and so many. But Krishna says, Manmana Bhagavata, you think of me. Because we have to think something. Without thinking, you cannot remain. This is the simple process. Instead of thinking so many things, you simply think of Krishna. The sadhu will teach that. Sadhu's business is why sadhu, to associate with sadhu, sadhu sangha. Sadhu will not teach anything else. Sadhu sadhya tato sadhu sangha. This is the process. I'm making spiritual advancement. If you have got any faith for making spiritual advancement, then you must associate with sadhus. Adau sadhya, just like here people come. Here there is no other thing because here all the boys and girls and devotees, they are concerned with Radha Krishna. That's the whole business, whole day's business, whole night's business is Radha Krishna. From early morning at 3 o'clock to night 10 o'clock, they have only business of Radha Krishna, that's all. Therefore they are sadhu. Therefore they are sadhu. This is the symptom of sadhu. And so many people are criticizing, so many enemies we have got, we are not getting the sanction because there are so many enemies. We are creating nuisance. We are chanting Hare Krishna mantra, that is nuisance. This complaint is going to the police. So that is very difficult. Therefore, a sadhu is advised, titiksava, tolerate all this nonsense. What can be done? We have no other alternative. To tolerate. Nobody is coming to help us. Our business is so thankless task because we are trying to create one temple. So many enemies, they are giving hindrance. You cannot do it. Therefore, titiksava. You have to remain sadhu. You cannot become a sadhu. You have to tolerate. What can be done? Tikiksava karunika. At the same time, you have to become merciful. You know what has happened in this place, Hare Krishna land. So much attack by the police, by the municipality to break this temple. So we could have gone. So what is the use of taking so much botheration? We have got hundreds of temples outside India. In Bombay, people are not liking. Let us go out. No. Karunika. We have come to distribute Krishna consciousness movement. We must tolerate and give this message to the people. Karunika. Very merciful. In spite of whole trouble. What is the use of these boys, these American boys, they have come to help me. Not that they are hungry, they have come here. No. My mission is that you American, you chant Hare Krishna so that India, people of India will see, oh, Americans, they are also chanting, why not ourselves? It is our property. But unfortunately, so much dull brain, but that is not coming. But still we have to do it. We have to tolerate and we have to become karunika. Therefore, it is said that paradukha dukhi, karunika. Why karunika? Why you want to be merciful? Na paradukha dukhi, kipam buddhijas tamaham prabhat. A Vaishnava business is paradukha dukhi. A Vaishnava understands that these people, they are engaged like cats and dogs in sense gratification. They are misguided, and they will be next life, they will be punished for this misguidance. Let us do something for them. This is karuna. Karuna. Karuna out of mercy. There is no question of getting something money. No, money we have got sufficient. Just to become merciful upon this fallen conditioned soul who are suffering on account of becoming animalistic without any Krishna consciousness. Therefore, the preacher, the sadhu, these are the sadhu, titiksava, tolerant, never mind. Whatever hindrances and tribulations they are offering to us, never mind. Tolerant. Titiksava karunika suhido. Suhido, when their heart is so nice, su means nice. And hido means heart. They have no other desire. Suhida means that like there are different words. Mitra, Suhida, Bandhu. In Sanskrit is very perfect language. Suhida means a person who is always thinking of welfare for others. He is called Suhida. Otherwise Kurida. The ordinary person, they are thinking how to make him subdued, how to make him defeated in competition, that is the polluted heart. And the Vaishnava, he is always thinking how a man can be saved from the clutches of Maya. He is called Suhida. He has no other desire. Suhida, sarvadehina, not for my brother or family, but sarvadehina, for all dehis, all dehis. It is not that, that this human, this like here, nationalism. What is this nationalism? Nationalism means to take care of the human being and send the cows and goats to the slaughterhouse. This is going on, nationalism. What is mean by nation? Nation, the definition is any living being born in that land, he is a national. So the cow is not born, the tree is not born in this land. But because they are not Krishna conscious, they cannot be kind to all the dehis. Sarvadehina. Dehi means anyone who has got this body. So somebody has got body, human being, somebody has got the cow's body, somebody has a dog's body, somebody has tree's body. then the Vaishnava is so kind that Sridha Sarvadehina. He is kind not only to the human being, to the cats, dogs, to the trees, to the plants, to the insect. A Vaishnava will hesitate even to kill one mosquito. Sarvadehina. Not that I shall take care of my brother. I am good and my brother is good. No. Sridha Sarvadehina. These are the Vaishnava qualifications. Titiksava karunika. Suhida sarvadehina ajata satrava. Because he is living in that way, why others will be enemy? Or he does not create enemy. They become enemy out of their own character. We do not create enemy. But due to the demonic qualification, how we can create enemy? Krishna says that sarva-dharmān parityajya-māmekaṁ saraṇaṁ vraja. We are simply teaching, my dear human being, my dear friend, you become a surrendered soul to Krishna. So what is our fault? So we don't create enemy, but they become enemy. We don't create enemy. Why shall I create enemy? Śrīdha sarva-dehinā, why shall I create enemy? But they become, out of their own nature, that's like serpent. Nobody creates a serpent enemy, but he is already enemy. Satpa krura khala krura, satpata krura tara khala. Chanakya Pandit says, there are two crooked animals or envious animals. What is that? One man envious, without any reason he becomes envious. And there is one serpent envious. Without any fault, it will bite and your death. Satpa krura khala krura. Similarly, there are men, without any offense, they will become enemy. Unnecessarily. So Chanakya Pandit says, satpa krura khala krura. There are two envious entities. Satpath krutara khala. The crooked man is more dangerous than the serpent. Why? Mantrausadhi vasa sarpa. Sarpa, the serpent can be subdued by mantra, by chanting, snake chanting mantra, or by some herbs. Khalakena nivarjate. The man envious, it cannot be subdued. Therefore, it is more dangerous than the serpent. So, we are in this society, human society, because we are spreading Krishna consciousness. The kuro, which is more dangerous than the snake, they are putting so many impediments, but we have to tolerate. We have no other alternative. You see? Ajata satrava shanta. Be peaceful. What can be done? Depend on Krishna. Sadhava. They are sadhu. They are sadhu. Sadhu shanta. These are the ornament of sadhu. What is that? Titiksava karunika suida sarvadina. Sadhu sukrita. But you must know what is sadhu. First sadhu is that he must be devotee. And if he is devotee, then all the symptoms are there. All the symptoms are there. These are the symptoms. Don't go to a sadhu. Shastra says this is the sadhu. Then you find out a sadhu and associate with him, then your path of liberation will be open. Thank you very much. Yeah.